I think it's better to speak from experience here. Like, you have seen the reality here and how vulnerable we are to climate change, especially the rising seas. So, yes, I think leaders around the world should be at least pay a visit to Tuvalu to see the climate change impact for themselves, so that they can speak from the experience and that they can also feel it to themselves.
Yeah, yeah. Well, if given that, what's your hope for Paris? What would you like to see?
Well, I'm hoping that the whole international community, especially our world leaders, will agree on a legally binding agreement that will put us, that will help us to remain on our own islands.
Yeah, and that would mean limiting the temperature to at least...
Yeah, to at least 1.5.
1.5. Well,
we've been arguing that in the international community, and I think Tuvalu and AOCs, LDCs and other low-lying communities will certainly go for 1.5. Although it is difficult for other world leaders, but it's all about survival.
Yeah.
I will take any chances that have been given to me, that will be given to me by PCP or whoever organized the delegation. I will take the opportunity not only to advocate our position on climate change from the perspective of those who have been living in Tuvalu, but I will also use the media as a way to convince not only other CSO partners, but also at least we can tap the international leaders to listen to our stories. I want my kids to grow up the way that I grew up. I want them to grow up and see our culture, our identity as Tuvaluans, our communal way of living, and our communal way of doing things. I want them to experience the same experience that I went through. But if the world don't do anything, or if nothing to change, then I am so sorry for them that I think certainly they have to find somewhere else to survive.